So, the last presentation before the lunch break, we have provided a little more lunch than yesterday, still within our tight cost budget here in Denmark. This is not really not easy. We will work through the budgetary issues then in the next weeks, I guess. Okay, but the last working group presentation, dissemination. I will basically go through what are we funded for, what dissemination activities we have budgeted and we have planned in the memorandum of understanding. But maybe the most important thing is what happens to the papers to this workshop. We have received quite a number of papers already, and some we have not received yet. So there is 2 more weeks to send us the papers, to send the papers to the working group leaders, who will compose a first or a working group report, which will then be compiled to the workshop report by us. And this workshop report will be published, and it gets an ISBN number. So this is a call to complete the paper writing, and this is the announcement that we will publish this in a book for this first workshop. Okay, what other means of dissemination do we have? But first, whom are we addressing? We are addressing, of course, the research community and the engineering community, structural engineers and builders. But also representatives of the construction and infrastructure industry. We are addressing European national associations and confederations, authority and policy makers at regional and European level. Again, yes, the research community, and of course, the scholars, teachers, lecturers, and students of structural design, engineering, architectural schools, maybe also some other touching fields. We have quite many of these are listed here, are already in the action. A little challenging, maybe the relevant European associations or policymakers at European levels. So this is something we may need ideas throughout the action for. Of course, the we have European and national associations already in, not least the JCSS, where this action was initiated by. Okay, so this is the people we are addressing. What and how do we disseminate? We have the website, we have the first version online that was done by basically us here at DTU. This is for dissemination, for information. It is, according to the memorandum of understanding, also for the exchange of documents and discussion platforms, online surveys, video streams of keynote presentations. So there can be much more to the webpage, and we will develop it further. We were also discussing with Helmut Wenzel, had a very good idea that we may create a group within ResearcherGate, so that we use the social networks which are relevant for researchers. So I think this is an idea to follow. And yes, So the development of the website will go on. When we are coming to workshop training schools and teaching, then of course we have here the first action workshop. But we may look in the future to do this in conjunction with events and conferences with related professional and scientific organizations. And the workshops should be directed in the first stage to scientific issues, as we have it here, and we will have it also in Istanbul for the workshop. There we are concentrating on scientific issues and later then on practical and dissemination aspects. So a clear event for period two is the rather large conference on materials, systems, and structures in civil engineering, where we already have set up a segment on value of information and structural health monitoring. So this is something I would like you to keep in mind. That will also take place here at DTU. And but of course we have discussions with Daniele Sonder also to associate the activities also to SHM conferences. I think this is also something something to be done, and we should, when we are doing the working plans for the next years, so we have the working plan for this year, for 2015. And at the end of the year, we will make it for 2016. So then we should have a discussion here on these topics again. What we need to develop is also educational activities. I think this may be sensible also in the later stages of the action. So as we have it also in the memorandum of understanding, that's dissemination and teaching of developed guidelines. So that would be at the very end. But I think we may set up before on theoretical issues, for instance, online courses. So I think we should, I would very much advocate the use of online courses. So I think this is a very efficient way to set up a course. And we have quite a number of excellent lecturers under us. And this would be in a very efficient way when we are using these mock or online courses that we can set up teaching activities, and this will also be efficient for us because we don't have to travel all the time. And short-term scientific missions. So this is to build up synergies between institutes. So we have budget for supporting researchers which are going from one cost country to another cost country to another institution, and spending their time working in this area. So Alan O'Connor is our scientific short-term scientific mission coordinator, and so far he has not received any applications. So we have budget, and applications are welcome, or also within this year. What and how should we disseminate further? We should disseminate at conferences, write peer-reviewed articles and state-of-the-art reports. So one state-of-the-art report, maybe the report we are producing from this meeting. And this is where we have a working group on standardization. This was covered by John already. Very important is that we have a working group on dissemination. And we will organize us in the consecutive working group meeting. We will think of who can contribute to what. And of course, this case goes to all the action members. Please ask for dissemination, working group 6 for help. Thank you for your attention.